So you clicked on this video, and that makes me think that you have an interest in ancient history, like for instance, ancient stone structures or theories surrounding the ancient world. Maybe you want to know more about new archaeological discoveries, or maybe you are like me and you want to know more about like the human evolutionary timeline. And if any of that is the case, then I highly suggest you subscribe to the channel and click that bell icon to be notified whenever I upload. And if you enjoy my work, maybe consider becoming a patron or a channel member. So think about the most significant innovation ever to have occurred in ancient times. Are you thinking of stone tools, or are you thinking of creating and controlling fire? If you were thinking the latter, then you were most likely right, as it is widely accepted that the control of fire is actually one of the most significant inventions or innovations of all time. There is a multitude of techniques to identify the use of fire in ancient times that's being used by archaeologists. But the technological advancements in this field are happening all the time, and thankfully, those new advancements bring about some wonderful new discoveries. Sorry for my raspy voice. My throat really got messed up on vacation. But my name is Kaylee, and in this video we are going to take a look into the latest study done in Israel, where they have discovered definitive proof of the creation and control of fire dating to at least 1 million years ago. So we have all wondered at some point when humans first started using fire. And when I say humans, I don't mean Homo sapiens, but I actually mean all species of humans that have come before us, as we Homo sapiens actually are quite a young species compared to the rest. We're new, we're the latest edition, so to say. Okay, well maybe not everyone has wondered about this, but I do realize that I'm really one of the strange few that has an insatiable interest in human evolution and the oldest or first things like the Ancient Inventions series that I started on this channel. Come to realize I'm probably quite a bit of a weirdo. But hey, you're watching me, so I'm just guessing you're equally as weird as me. I'm addicted to finding out the first use of something or the invention of something. So like how the different ancient species lived, how they evolved, how they developed and spread over the earth. And the use of fire seems to be one of the biggest reasons for these species to have succeeded and thrived and reached the top of the food chain, as they did. Fire seemed to be the number one reason that eventually all these species kept evolving and led to us. So up until now, the archaeologists had a few techniques to identify the use of fire by ancient humans, but I can name a few. We can look at discoloration of bones, and you can sometimes see that stone tools are warped in a way that is consistent with the heat of fire of more than 450 degrees Celsius. I'll put the Fahrenheit on the screen because, please don't. Please don't forgive me. But the difficulty this last mentioned technique brings with it is the fact that going back to more than 500,000 years in the past, we rarely, if ever, see evidence of anything being heated above 450 degrees Celsius. It's unclear if the evidence degrades too much over time, or if the fires created from before 500,000 years ago simply weren't as big or as hot as the later created fires. So that's a big question mark. Thankfully, there is now a new type of technology that can be used to discover the hidden evidence of the ancient use of fire, and it has actually already revealed some incredible results. So a group of researchers in Israel unveiled a new deep learning artificial intelligence tool last year that is able to identify a more subtle sign of fire. Fire that reached a temperature between some 200 and 300 degrees Celsius, which is already a lot cooler compared to the previously needed 450 degrees Celsius. It's like put that in half, and that's amazing. But how were they able to do this, you may ask? So the team trained the artificial intelligence algorithm by gathering pieces of flint from non-archaeological sites in Israel They then heated these pieces to certain temperatures inside the lab in a controlled environment, and then tasked the artificial intelligence algorithm to identify the subtle changes within the flint and the way that it responds to UV light. This team then collaborated with Michael Chazan, which is the founding director of the Archaeology Center and a Paleolithic archaeologist at the University of Toronto in Canada. And they let the algorithm take a look at pieces of flint from the Evron quarry site in Israel that dates back to approximately 1 million years ago. So we already know the age of the site, so we conclude the age of the tools found within those borders of the site as well. So the reason for choosing the Evron quarry was simple. The same kind of flint was used and found at this site that they had already researched in a previous study, so it's easier to compare the results. The other reason why they picked the Evron quarry site and its flint contents was because they had no reason at all to believe that any of the flint pieces at this site were ever subject to burning, because there were no other traces of burning discovered at the site, no traces of a fire at the site, so nothing to even lead them to believe that anything was ever heated at this site. But to the surprise of the researchers, the artificial intelligence algorithm did indeed suggest that many of the flint tools that were discovered at the Evron quarry site were heated to temperatures around 400 degrees Celsius. So not only did the AI tool show that there had indeed been use of fire at this site, but it also showed that the fire was actually at quite the high temperature, and these tools date back to approximately 1 million years ago, which all of that added together is quite the significant discovery. So because of the fact that the researchers had not expected to find any evidence of the use of fire on the flint tools, this team then decided to look at the pieces of bones that were discovered at the Evron quarry site as well. So they used existing techniques to see if these bones were ever subjected to heating, and they indeed found evidence for this. So according to the team, they would have never tested these bones for heat exposure if these flint tools had never shown any signs of being heated with the use of this new artificial intelligence tool. So that's quite amazing. And because of the clustering in the heated stone tools and in the bones, it is actually highly unlikely that this was a natural occurring fire. And all evidence points to the ancient humans living in and around this quarry site to have controlled fire. So this actually means that we now, for the first time ever, have conclusive evidence for the creation and the control of fire dating back to at least 1 million years ago. But as this team might continue their research at other ancient sites, we might be able to find out much more ancient evidence with even older dates. So there is a small amount of evidence pointing to ancient humans having controlled and used fire approximately 1.5 million years ago. And this artificial intelligence algorithm tool can definitely aid in the research to prove this. And the team actually even thinks that we might be able to find much older dates as well, as there is a very popular theory suggesting that the creation and the use of fire and thus cooking might have been widespread as early as 2 million years ago, which is double the amount of what we currently factually have proven. And this actually has to do with the fact that brains started to grow larger and guts started to evolve smaller between 2 million and 1.8 million years ago. And they feel like there's a correlation between the use of fire and this evolutionary shift inside the morphology of these ancient humans. Bigger brains, smaller guts. This used to sound absolutely ludicrous, but now Chazan and the team actually find it at least likely that we might be on the verge of proving this theory right or wrong with the help of this new artificial intelligence tool. Who knows what else we will uncover? It seems like this world is still filled with wonders, and we're only seeing the tip of the iceberg when it comes to what we have uncovered and unraveled so far about the ancient world. But with that said, I am back from vacation. I have a nice tan. I feel okay, not as rested as I would have hoped, but I'm all right. I'll be back with regular videos once more. I've missed all of you. And yeah, with that said, if you enjoyed watching, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, and click that bell icon if you want to be notified whenever I upload. If you haven't seen my previous videos yet, because I saw that not many of you were actually watching me while I was gone, and it actually made me really sad, so click in the upper right corner to watch previous videos of mine. And otherwise, you can click in the links in the description down below or click a video in the end card. And I want to thank all my patrons and my channel members. Thank you so much for supporting me. If you enjoy my work and you want to support me, maybe consider becoming a patron or a channel member, or leave a super chat or a super thanks in the comments. Whatever, feel free. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys.